And welcome to the Technology Geek Podcast. I am your host, Brandon Lapani, the Technology Geek. And we're here as we are to computers, the internet, home theater, all gadgets, and anything really. So this is our 26th podcast, 26 already. It's pretty amazing that we did 26 of them already. It's good. They go pretty quick. So a lot of things going on in tech, as they always are. Some other things as well going on in the world of technology. Just a lot going on. We actually made some improvements here to the actual equipment we use here for the Technology Geek podcast. We added a new mixing board here. We added a couple of other things as well as we're doing. We're actually recording now via YouTube, so we're very grateful. We're going to be adding more of a visual element, hopefully, to the show. We'll see how that goes. It's going to be, different. Some different we're trying here. This is going to get tired one. So if you're watching us on YouTube, instead of getting just the audio, now you're going to actually get the video with it. So we'll see how that goes. As well as two of you, as most of you noticed here, I added a bouncy ball here, added an exercise ball here, sitting on an event in a chair. Here's supposed to be good for your, tightening up your core muscles and things like that. So we'll see how it goes. Right now, I'm sitting here, sitting bounce around here as I blog and do my podcasting. So it's kind of neat. So we'll see how it goes. And like I said, it's something new we're trying here as far as the YouTube piece and all that stuff. So just bear with us. Like I said, it's the first time we're doing it. So we'll see how it goes. So before we go any further, obviously let me do our talk to our sponsors. Obviously, ProXPN.com, a wonderful VPN solution. We've had them for years now, and I've used them. I mean, they're a great service, cloud-based, VPN solutions. They're really, really wonderful. I like them very much. And again, that's proxpn.com, and the coupon code is TechGeek, TECGEK. And let's not forget, of course, about another huge sponsor of ours, Audible. You get a 30-day free trial of Audible with our subscription. It's audibletrial.com/techgeek. And they're really a wonderful service. I like listening to audiobooks on the go and stuff. They're actually really, a really wonderful service, and I haven't found a book on there that I can't get a hold of. So they're really wonderful service. We're very lucky to have them. And then that's audibletrial.com/techgeek, and as well as our Dollar Shave Club. Dollar Shave Club, again, they're like the Netflix of shaving equipment. You go ahead and you could you send them like $6 a month, and they mail you 4 razors a month. It's actually cheaper than going to the pharmacy or any place like that to go ahead and get, those razors. And they're cheaper than Gillette or any of those. So they're really, really good. I like them a lot. And again, go to our website, thetechnologygeek.org, and you can go ahead and get our offer right from there. So now that we got all the sponsors out of the way, we got the good housekeeping out of the way here. So a lot going on in tech this week. A lot of things going on. By the way, folks, I just want to say one thing. The podcast has done really, really well, and we decided we're going to add a visual element by using YouTube and all that. And we've been up on Reddit, YouTube now. First time, like I said, we always uploaded the podcast to YouTube, but we never actually did a full visual element. So we're trying that now. But SoundCloud, iTunes, obviously. The podcast is doing very well, so they do appreciate that. We've been off for 2 weeks now, due to just some things we got going on, and I just wasn't able to get it up. I try to get it up, every week, but sometimes, unfortunately, it just doesn't work that way. But, I'm trying to get it up, every week, and hopefully we will. I like doing it. It's really, very important that, we get it up on a regular basis, but sometimes, fortunately, with running another business on top of this, sometimes, unfortunately, things do get in the way a little bit, so I'm sorry for that, but we'll do our best, like I said, to try to go ahead and get this up, every week, but last week just wasn't able to. Some other things as far as the website goes, obviously we're blogging, every day. We do have a blog every day, and the forums, don't forget about the forums. The forums are great. A lot of questions can be answered on there. The website, and also too, folks, we do take donations on there as well. We appreciate any donations you can give us. Bandwidth is expensive. You know, we do donate some of our time to do this. So anything you guys could go ahead and just help keep the site going, we'd greatly appreciate it. You guys have been great with the sponsors, but, donations themselves would be fantastic. If you guys can go ahead and do that, we'd greatly appreciate it. Today one of the topics I was going to bring up on the podcast, obviously we talk about some stuff for a little bit, and then we go on to the news and your questions. But the first thing I want to say, Tom Clancy passing away at 66, and his new movie scheduled to come out very, very soon here. The gentleman that played in Star Trek is going to be in it. So I'm very unfortunate to see him pass away. Wonderful, wonderful writer, and 66 was very, very young. So I want to wish the best to his family and all that type of stuff. Very sad, very sad. So the topic I wanted to talk about this week, talking about SEO strategies. SEO strategies. A lot of people don't. Search engine optimization is a huge thing nowadays. A lot of people get into it. A lot of companies out there doing it. It is kind of a bloated market. But there's a lot of stuff you can do with your website alone. That'll go ahead and help with your SEO strategy. One thing I always tell people all the time, first thing you do when you set up a website, you always set up, your Google Analytics. Google Analytics are a huge, huge piece of that. If you don't have Google Analytics, your chances of getting recognized are Google likes to know what you're doing, because the more Google knows, the higher up your site's going to go. That's just the way it is. Always submitting your site. There's an article up on the Technology Geek. You can go to our website and look at it. It talks about submitting your website to Google. But definitely analytics is something that everybody who has a website should definitely do. Google Analytics, so important. And no matter who you are, you should definitely go up there and open up an analytics account. Some other things you can do as well to help. To help your site out. The Google Webmasters has a huge tool set there. You should definitely get yourself a Google Webmaster Tools. By the way, all these stuff I'm telling you about are free, by the way. You should definitely get yourself a Google Webmasters Tool. It's definitely something that's worth it. Google Webmaster Tools are very, very powerful tools, and let you know how many backlinks you have, let you know what the search queries people are searching for. It lets you know there's so much great information, and it's very, very important that you have Google Webmaster Tools set up, and then you link it with your analytical data. It's very, very important. And one of the things about Google Webmaster Tools is as well is it lets you go ahead and crawl and shows you what Google's crawling, what Google's searching, and all that. It's very, very important. Data to have, and you definitely should go ahead and sign up for that, and definitely the analytics piece. That's huge. If you don't get Google Analytics, you're not doing your website any justice, because it's so important, and Google really does use that data when it comes to searching. So that's something you should definitely take your time and do. Some other things as well, when it comes to Webmaster Tools. Some other things to look at. It shows you what sites link back to yours, which a lot of people don't realize how important backlinking is when you start talking about you heard the term a lot on the internet, link weight. A lot of people don't realize how important link weight and all that really is. When talking about analytics, when a lot of people get backlinks from spam places and stuff like that, that actually hurts your ranking, rather than help it. And it's really important that you go ahead and really work on working on getting strong backlinks. I'll give you a prime example, like a backlink from, say, like a Tumblr site that's got a lot of spam, which is probably like a page rank of zero. That would actually bring down your page ranking, whereas like a link from a place like Facebook or a link from like YouTube would actually increase your link weight and would actually push you up higher. And also too, the the links going out from your site are just as important as the ones going into your site. So a lot of times when you write a post, I'm talking about, like, if you have a website and you started a blog, it'd be very, very important for you to go ahead and if you're writing, let's give you a prime example. A week from now, The Walking Dead show comes on again. Say you're writing an article about that. If you actually link out to AMC somewhere in your site, you would actually get that article would have a lot more link weight because it's linking to a legit place. So the links coming in as well as the links going out are very, very important when talking about, your Google page ranking and all that type of stuff. And if you do have a website, I strongly recommend you starting a blog because it is very, very important. And you can definitely get yourself quite a bit of, link weight from a blog, word count. A lot of people don't realize that word count is really important as well. Say you're a website that does computer security. Well, if you blog every day about computer security, the word security and the word computer are going to get much more denser on a website with a blog than one that just has just a plain website. Some other things as well, too, when you start building websites and talking about SEO, it's very, very important to go ahead and to actually use, certain sites, like a lot of those page builders and stuff like that, that you see on, Yahoo or you see on a lot of those other places. They don't actually have great SEO. They don't do the metadata right. They don't do anything like that. It's very, very important that you go ahead and you get the proper metadata and all that, and make sure that your site is crawlable by Google. A lot of people just don't think they can just throw a page up in 10 minutes because of one of those page builder sites, and they think they're gonna get a level 5 page ranking. It doesn't work that way. You really need to put the time in and build it using something like a WordPress template or a Drupal or getting, maybe if you're a big enough company, you might want to put the money out and get one designed for you. It's very, very important. And it's one of the things that a lot of people actually don't realize. Another thing as well, too, another thing that will really help your page ranking as well is when you put images on pages, making sure to use the proper page, the proper when naming this, if you're naming image one, image two, image three, you might want to call it whatever it's relating to. So if it was a computer, pick a picture of a computer, you might want to call it just computer. Another thing too, when naming things, even on the site yourself, don't use underscores, in any of your naming, because Google for some reason does not like underscores. So go ahead and actually use a dash. Don't use an underscore. Underscores are actually really bad. They actually hurt your page ranking tremendously. I recommend not using them. Some other things as well when it's talking about when talking about stuff like page ranking and all that type of stuff. When you start really looking at a website and looking how it's built, always build websites for people. Don't build it for, don't think of, if you put the word security a million times on a page, the odds are a chance Google's going to pick that up as spam. It's not going to do you any justice. And a lot of people don't realize that. And it is really, really important that you go ahead and don't have any spam links. Be careful who's linking back to you. Be careful what kind of spam comments, especially. A lot of people don't realize that. They take any comments that come in, and believe it or not, if you have a comment that's spam, can actually hurt that particular page and hurt your page ranking. Some other things as well to think about as well, when you're designing a site, obviously your forums, obviously Simple Machine forums are the best. There's a lot of plugins and all types of stuff. So if you are going to have a forum, use Simple Machine forums, and actually to get SEO plugins. And another thing that's very important too, we were talking about a minute ago about, Google Webmaster Tools. Another thing to make sure you do with Google Webmaster Tools, make sure that whatever site you use has a sitemap and submit that sitemap to Google Webmaster Tools, because it tells Google what's on your site and tells it how to crawl. Some other things as well, too. You know, if you get a virus on a site or something like that, you know, sometimes Google will red flag it. That's really important. If you get something like that, make sure you contact Google immediately and go ahead and get, you know, go ahead and make sure you get Google to, you know, tell them you cleaned the site. The site's cleaned up. It's not virus infected anymore. And hopefully they'll un-red flag it. A lot of times it's very hard to do if you actually get a site that actually gets, if the site gets blacklisted, sometimes it's very, very hard to get off it. Depending on the site itself. So that's something you might want to think about as well. When doing this, when designing a page, check the URL and make sure that, it's not blacklisted. Some other things too, when talking about, web development and stuff like that, always make sure, your robots.txt is set up properly. Most of the sites nowadays are set up so the website, the robot.txt is properly set up, but some places don't. When you set up for a Google Webmasters account, you can actually go ahead in there and look and see what the robot.txt's text is. And you can double check it and make sure that the robots.txt is set up properly so it's not blocking any sites that it's not supposed to. Some other things as well, in the Google Webmaster Tools, you can see you can see what search queries you're getting. You can look at internal links. Linking internally to your site is very important too. Having a home button, having proper linking, a good site map, of your site, good drop down menus. That's all very important when it comes to designing a website. We were just talking about word density a few minutes ago in Google Webmaster's Tools. You can actually go ahead and see your keyword density. You can see any crawler errors, crawler status. If you have a particular page that for some reason doesn't seem to be getting indexed, you can go ahead and submit it there. You could block a URL if you don't want Google to search a particular URL. If it's going to be private or for internal use only, you'd block it there. It'll tell you about any malware. They even have some labs in there as well that you can use, and it actually is quite a useful tool. So I would strongly recommend, using Google Webmaster Tools. And you submit your site. So for our site, we have it submitted twice. It's thetechnologygeek.org and then www.thetechnologygeek.org. So submit it both ways. So this way you go ahead and get the most out of it. And then you submit the sitemap twice and a lot of other things you can do multiple times. And it'll actually work out really, really well for you. There's a lot of things you can really do. One of the things that somebody said, we're going to do a podcast on podcasting equipment and stuff like that. We probably could, but we haven't yet. Maybe that'll be next week. We'll see what happens. Podcasting is a very important thing, but it works differently than search engine optimization. And I can explain all that, a little bit, when I do the podcasting episode. Podcasts, despite all the words you're saying, Google doesn't index MP3s like it does website words. So it's a little bit different, and we can go in, of course, to all that. Some other things as well, talking about SEO. When you go into Google Analytics, there's actually a section in there where you can actually go ahead and add in all your face, your company Facebook page, your company Google Plus, your company Twitter, all that stuff, and that's really, really important because Google actually does take social media information into account now, where it didn't, a few years ago. So it's very, very important to get all that, data in there, and to really, really make sure that, that you're getting all your search engine data in there, and making sure that, that Google's seeing, all your tweets, all your Facebooks, all your YouTube posts, all that, because that all counts towards link weight and link popularity. If you look at a site like Wikipedia, I mean, they're always, I mean, search anything, Wikipedia is always within the first five, and they're always in the front page. So that's really, really important. And it's really, really important to make sure that, you know, when you talk about link weight and link popularity, they're very, very important when pertaining to how high up on Google your site's going to get. But it is definitely important to make sure that when talking about link weight and all that type of stuff, that you're making sure you have strong backlinks, you know, not spam links, you know, anything like that. Making sure you do good, solid links from good, reputable sites. It's very, very important. And when it comes to the Google Webmaster Tools and the Google Analytics, those are the two things you'd set up first when setting up a website. The other thing as well, too, don't forget Bing has an analytical piece that you can use. They have the same thing, analytics and Webmaster Tools. They have it all bundled up into one. But it's very important to get on Bing, too, because Bing does have a chunk of the market. And as well, too, Yahoo doesn't have a Webmaster Tools piece anymore. So it's very, very important to go ahead and sign up for Bing, because Bing sends their data over to Yahoo. So it's actually a pretty good thing to do, because not only will you get Bing, you'll get Yahoo. So it's really, really important to you know, to go ahead and do that. So I would definitely sign up for Bing. I mean, I know Bing is a small part of the market, but it's definitely an important part of the market. So, trying to think. I think that's about it for my notes on SEO. You know, also in the crawler, there are search appearance. It'll tell you the site, the HTML improvements you can make. You know, it's a really, really powerful tool that I think anybody with a website should definitely, you know, sign up for. And, you know, analytics, I mean, that could be his own podcast in itself. I mean, there's so much Google Analytics collects, it's just amazing. And especially that's something you should really know. It'll tell you if a lot of your hits are coming from computers, if they come from mobile devices, if they're iOS devices, if they're Android devices. It'll tell you if it's Firefox, Chrome. It'll tell you what part of the country it's coming from. You know, it'll tell you if it's coming from out of the country. It'll tell you even what ISPs, the information is coming from, if it's local, remote. There's a lot of information that analytics can tell you that you can use to put towards your marketing strategies as a business. So it is very, very important, and I strongly recommend doing it. And I mean, I know a lot of places. If you're trying to start a blog or even a or a podcast or anything like that, and you want sponsors, they'll actually ask for a month or sometimes a year worth of analytical data before they decide if they're going to advertise on your site, because they want to look at that data to see if you're the best fit for, you know, their particular site. And, you know, and just as well as to see, you know, if it's worth them doing a one-time fee or a pay-per-click or anything like that. So it is very, very important to go ahead and make sure you have that analytical data, especially if you're selling advertising on your site. They're going to ask for that information. And I can tell you this, without Google Analytics, you won't move up the search engine rankings very, very quickly, because Google takes that information very, very seriously. So, but I think that's for the most part all on search engine optimization. Let's see what else we have. Well, we can go right to the news. Obviously we had a podcast in 2 weeks, so there's a lot going on with the. With the news, we can go ahead and we'll go right through the news. So as far as the news goes, I'm not going to give you news from 2 weeks old, but I am going to give you some of the news news that we haven't really talked about too much, and that we probably should go over, even though it's a little old, but it's important to talk about. Obviously, Kim.com suing, for $4.5 million, suing New Zealand over illegal surveillance and all that type of stuff. He had to step down as a CEO of his own company because he's got to fight this extradition. He dealt with, his site Mega being taken down. He dealt with a lot of stuff that I think, he's dealt with a lot of over the last couple of years. So I think he's kind of wants to fight back, and I think you're going to see more from him as time progresses. So. Some other news as well. Netflix wins two Emmy nominations for House of Cards. Netflix wins two Emmy nominations for House of Cards over major TV dramas. So that was in the news. That was something that when they first did that. Said they were going to do a series. A lot of people were like, I don't know. But now Hulu's doing their own. Amazon Prime is doing their own. Anything to really go ahead and compete with Netflix and HBO. Because they're the two big names in the industry when you're talking about original content. Yes, so they, Netflix previously snagged two Emmys confirmed. They won for outstanding cinematography for a single camera series for a drama, defeating Breaking Bad, Game of Thrones, and Mad Men. And then there was. I'm looking through the article here. I don't see what the other one was, but they did win two. I'm positive of that. Up to nine, prime, nine. It doesn't say what the. The creative arts behind the scene achievements was one of the other ones they got. It's actually pretty neat to see, and really gives the Netflix the proper credibility, because they ate a lot of junk from a lot of people when they said they were going to start doing original content. And it really worked out for them in the end. So good for them. AMC announces a Walking Dead spinoff series. We're just talking about The Walking Dead. That's going to premiere. I think it's going to premiere. It premieres next week. But at Comic-Con, they showed about a 5-minute trailer. And it looks really good. But they're apparently going to be doing a spinoff show. Not a whole lot of information on that yet. They're just saying they're going to do a spinoff. I'd be interested to see what the actual spinoff is going to be about. I do have the link. Let me see if there's any additional information. Plotting a spinoff called Spread the Dead, which will feature a new cast associated with Robert Kirkman's Walking Dead comic books. It's scheduled to premiere in 2015. And that's about it. That's pretty much all we know right now. Let's see what else. The Microsoft Surface promotion offers iPad owners a trade-in deal. That's something Microsoft's doing. I kind of figured that was going to happen. It's been great watching the watching the Microsoft commercials, watching them talking about bashing the iPad. I'm not a huge Surface fan, but I can tell you, I think it is pretty funny that they're just bashing Microsoft is bashing the iPad, saying, "Oh, you know, they go to people go to put an SD card in, and it's like, oh, I can't accept that. I'm sorry." And then, they shows the multitasking app. It's like, I can only do one thing at once. It's actually really, really cool to watch those, and I enjoy watching them. I do, but I'm sure Apple's not happy about it. Microsoft Surface promotion offering iPad owners a trade-in deal. So that's something definitely that is pretty cool. And I kind of figured they were going to do that, with everything going on. So trying to see what else we have going on here. It looks like it's going to offer iPad 2, 3, and 4. It's going to offer, and you're going to receive a $200 gift card for trading in, your iPad. So, pretty cool deal if you're interested in that. I don't know too many people that that like Surface tablets, but if you're into that kind of thing, go right ahead and trade yours in and get a better one. So the FBI admits to controlling Tor servers behind massive malware attack. That was up on Slashdot the other day. Tor is actually a really, really neat service. And unfortunately, lately, they've been getting just really picked apart with everything going on lately. And as we wait for it to load. But, Tor is definitely cool. But, see, the thing is, if they monitor the end nodes, they can get a lot more information. And that's what they've been doing. They're monitoring end nodes, and that's how they've been picking up on all this stuff going on. The FBI, definitely monitoring that. And it's definitely something that, I don't know, I just think that... I think Tor is very secure, but if you're coming off an end node, you're gonna get hit, so... Tor is definitely cool. We've actually done a podcast on Tor earlier, one of our earlier podcasts. Tor is actually really cool because it's peeling back the layers in the onions. You bounce around on a bunch of different servers, so it kind of gives you that anonymity. But when you come out an end node, if somebody's monitoring and the end nodes you come out on, they're going to see what you're doing, and that's the weakness it has in it, and that's what the FBI use. But Tor is a great thing. It really, really is a wonderful service. But problem is, people use, I've said this before, people use good things for bad things. And unfortunately, people use it for stuff that's not nice. And now they're cracking down on it. Just like BitTorrent. BitTorrent's a great thing, but people are using it to distribute, movies and stuff like that. So now they've had a crack down on it. So, it's not really a good thing when people use grid services for stuff like that. So, some other news as well, talking about, Bill Gates, obviously, a couple weeks ago, he was declared the 20th for the 20th straight year in a row. He was declared the richest man in the world at $72 billion. So he's not hurting. A lot of stuff going on with Bill Gates. Obviously, the shareholders right now want him to step down as the board of directors, which, I mean, when Gates was in charge, Microsoft was in its heyday. Now all of a sudden they want him to step down because Microsoft's had some rough times. And they've had rough times because of Ballmer, not because of Gates. But, okay, obviously, they want him to go ahead and step down now, and I don't think they have any right to really ask him to step down. I mean, he's done a great job as CEO, in my opinion, and I don't think they have any rights to step down. Have they had some problems because of Ballmer? Yeah, but why should they ask Gates to step down as the board of director? I mean, he's selling off all his Microsoft stock. He won't even have any ownership of Microsoft by 2018. So why they're asking him to step down is beyond me. I think that they seriously need to go ahead and, I mean, they definitely need a change up. Bomber leaving, somebody else will be in charge now. The guy that they originally thought was going to be in charge, the guy that was in charge of Windows, obviously is no longer there anymore. So they're going to have to pick somebody else. But, I mean, Gates was a great CEO. He's been great as the head of the board of directors. Why they're asking him to step down is beyond me. I think it's just a bunch of people, you know, really, I think it's a couple of people that just don't know what they're doing is what it comes down to. Of course, that's the problem with going public, you know, people that keep, anybody can buy stock, even if they don't know what's going on with the company. Some other news as well, you know, we're talking about Netflix. Netflix, obviously, kind of neat. There was an article the other day on them talking about how they actually follow pirates to actually see what they're downloading, to know what shows they want to pick up. And, you know, Netflix has been really, really neat with doing a lot of things as far as a lot of times a lot of companies are forced to give their company the companies are forced, you know, if I'm going to buy content, you know, I'm going to get a couple of A-list shows and a bunch of B-list shows that the company, you know, that the companies are going to want to get off the ground, or studios are going to want to get off the ground. Netflix has a lot of sway in the industry, and they've been able to get A-list content without having to take the B-list stuff with it, picking and choosing shows. So, but now apparently they're following what they're actually looking on the internet to see what is downloaded on a weekly basis, so they actually know what to go ahead and purchase, which is really cool. There was also too. There was some other things. Android vulnerability allowed hackers to install malicious apps, but obviously that's been patched, so we're just going to fly right over that one. NSA Intelligence Agency spies on internal credit card transactions, including Visa. That was on the Hacker News the other day. Obviously, there was a hacker put up an Android Firefox zero-day exploit and put it up for sale. That was on the Hacker News the other day as well. There was another thing too. Hackers can easily hijack your eBay account in a minute. That was obviously up on the Hacker News. But again, all this stuff has been patched. This is a little bit older news that I just wanted to go over. But I'm not gonna start a discussion on it because again, it's older news and it's not really that important. Because a lot of stuff's been patched. One thing, though, an update to an article that we had on our site that we did talk about, the WikiLeaks server did sell out to somebody for $33,000. It was a young kid that was really big into WikiLeaks and history and some of that, and he bought it using his dad's eBay account, and he spent $33,000, but they're not going to let him have it because he used it using somebody else's eBay account, which you're not allowed to do, so... unfortunately, I don't know if they're going to relist it or what, but unfortunately, the kid's not going to go ahead, and he's not going to get he's not going to get the server because obviously you can't use somebody else's eBay account. So, fortunately, that kid is going to be, unfortunately, kind of maybe probably you know, he's probably grounded by now. My kid spent $33,000 on my eBay account. I'd be really upset about that. He's probably grounded, but he won't be able to get the server. Google, some other news coming up as well. Google not taking down the Pirate Bay. You know, a lot of people search Google for stuff like that, and they find stuff on Pirate Bay through Google. But apparently Google refusing to take down Pirate Bay from their site. They said they're still going to index it. They're still going to search it. Despite what the FBI and stuff asking them to take it down. So that's kind of neat. I thought that was kind of neat. Google's still, you know, still supporting the site, even though that it's a, not so much an illegal site, but, I mean, there's a lot of content on there. The majority of Pirate Bay site stuff is illegal. You know, it's pirated, but some of the stuff up there is still fairly good, but very little of it anymore. But yeah, Google's still refusing to take it down. Microsoft. Obviously, Microsoft, with everything going on right now, those of you watching me in the visual feed, you've seen watching me bounce around here on this exercise ball here. Still getting used to being stable on this. I'm still kind of learning yet. I just got this thing a couple days ago, so forgive me, those of you watching me. I'm hoping I'm not getting any motion sickness. Microsoft, obviously, increased their dividend plan into a $40 billion buyback. That was obviously, in the news. You know, Facebook has a quarter of a trillion user photos. That was up on Mashable the other day. I knew they had a lot, but I didn't think it was that much. Some other things as well in the news. Obviously, Microsoft. Let me try that one again. Microsoft unveils new abstract Bing logo. That's pretty neat. Really, you know, kind of changed the Bing logo a little bit. So, Google buys Bump, maker of contact info exchange app. So that was up on the Bing site the other day. Small thing as well that I think is kind of neat. Grand Theft Auto 5 reveals that they were having struggling servers. They released a patch to fix it the other day, but they were struggling quite a bit there. A lot of things, too, as we know, Jeff Bezos bought the actually went ahead and bought the Washington Post, but the old Washington Post building is being remodeled and turned into a $2 million luxury hotel by Donald Trump, so I thought that was kind of interesting. I figured I'd throw that in there. Some other things as well. A couple of things I want to bring up as well. A lot of people know I'm a ham radio operator. There's the 80th anniversary of the Collins Radio Company the other day. I'll throw that up in the show notes. Adobe, which had a hack today. Not much info on the hack yet, but they did get hacked. So it's up on the it's up on the internet. But I don't have a lot of information on it just yet. Obviously, they launched a Photoshop photography program with a special offer. That was up on Adobe site the other day. Amazon Instant Video gets AirPlay support for Apple TV. That was also in the news this past week as well. Some other stuff as well. Internet Explorer has a zero-day exploit that prompts Microsoft to publish an emergency fix. That was in the news this week as well. Hulu actually acquires a big deal with BBC for 144 shows, including Doctor Who. That's huge for Hulu, by the way, folks. I'm actually not a huge Hulu fan because I don't particularly care for Hulu, and I'll tell you the reason why. I don't like the fact that I'm buying the service, and as well, not only am I buying the service, but now I'm also getting commercials with it. So, I just don't really care. I think if I'm paying for the service, I shouldn't actually have to deal, with commercials. But some other interesting news here that just happened in our office. Apparently, the camera that I am using to do the YouTube part apparently just locked up, and I just lost my entire YouTube video stream. Well, that's lovely. Okay, well, I guess there's not going to be a live YouTube stream this week. I guess we'll have to try test run that again next week. I'm sorry about that, folks. I didn't know that was going to happen. So we'll get back to the news. Adobe engineering manager is at Yahoo now. Yahoo actually acquisitioned them. I got to say, I give Melissa, a lot of credit. She's doing a great, Melissa Mayer's doing a great job over at Yahoo, really, really helping that company get back, back in the swing of things where they should be. Wonderful for her. She's doing a wonderful job as CEO. Definitely something that, Yahoo needed. Some other things as well going on here. We'll talk about Microsoft again a little bit more. I'm talking about Microsoft a lot. I think more today than we've done in a lot of podcasts. So, Microsoft, obviously, Windows 8.1 going to be free to Windows 8 users. Going to cost $119.99 for others. So it's definitely news. And it's actually available right now for pre-order. So we're talking more about Microsoft this podcast than we have in the future. So that's good. Good for them. Podcast. Talk about some other things too. Pandora's allegedly supposed to be getting podcasts. It might be a rumor, but we'll see how that goes. Pandora getting a new logo, redesigning the iOS app. That was with the new iOS. Yahoo pushes out a new fresh, logo, and as well as Facebook, they all launched new logos for the new iOS rollout a couple weeks ago. So that was kind of interesting. Some other things new as well. That wasn't a huge piece of news, and I'm sure everybody knows it, but that Grand Theft Auto making $800 million in one day was actually very, very, very cool. I thought that was really neat. Some other things as well. Google launches a new company aimed at human lifespan, trying to expand the human lifespan. So that's something else that was in the news as well. Microsoft saying they're going to have to reamp Windows Explorer, IE 11, Internet Explorer 11, from Windows 7 users. So, I'm not exactly sure what that means just yet, but I'm sure we'll find out, as things progress over the next couple of weeks, because we all know that Microsoft really they've been struggling with their Internet Explorer releases. 10 was good, but there was no support for it when it rolled out. 9 kind of stunk. So there's a lot. Nine actually looks quite a bit like Chrome. So with it struggling a little bit. So we'll see what happens with that. Linus Torvalds again in the news saying that. He's never been asked to insert a backdoor, into Linux. Then he said it was a joke. Then he said it wasn't a joke. So he was the topic of some news, this past within the recent week. So that was kind of neat. So Linus again in the news. So what I've been hearing as well, some neat things going on as far as Yahoo. Again, we're talking about them again. iGoogle obviously nearing the end of its life, and apparently, Yahoo starting to get, because Yahoo still has their kind of iGoogle type interface. So apparently, they've been gaining quite a bit of ground on that front. Obviously because iGoogle's leaving. Definitely Yahoo picking up some lists, some people for using them as their homepage rather than Google. So definitely a good strategic move by Yahoo to leave that up. But Yahoo's Google's loss is Microsoft is Yahoo's gain. Good for them. And look at Feedy. Feedy alone. Look at Feedly. Look at what they did. Look at how much ground they gained because of the Google Reader being put to rest. Feedly said they almost doubled or almost tripled the amount of people they got just because everybody had to jump ship because Google Reader just kind of went away. So one company's loss is another company's gain. Small things as well. BlackBerry sold less than 2 million BB10 smartphones last quarter. Definitely BlackBerry in a serious, serious financial crisis right now. They definitely are going to need to do something if they're going to survive. They're not, the answer is that they're not going to survive unless they seriously do something differently than what they're doing right now. Which I don't know. I can't imagine them recovering from something like this. So, they've talked bankruptcy. They've talked a lot of things. I can't really picture them bouncing back. Microsoft obviously, bounced back by changing to a services company. And, Microsoft does have a lot of cool things out there right now, which is kind of one of the things that's keeping them going. They have SharePoint in the cloud, SECM in the cloud, Exchange in the cloud. They're adapting to the cloud and making a run of it because they're offering their services that used to be hosted externally for smaller places like smaller amenities, school districts, stuff like that. But they're going to survive because of what they're doing. Whereas, like BlackBerry has not changed at all. They tried to touch their touchscreen, the Thunder, I think it was. It failed terribly. They're just not going to survive with the way they are right now. Talking about a company like Microsoft, yeah, they had their ups and downs this year, absolutely. But I think taking their services and offering them up in the cloud, like they have, is definitely going to help them rebound as a company. Yes, Ballmer's leaving. within a year. But I'm sure, you know, I'm sure taking Microsoft, you know, Bill Gates off the board of directors would just be another huge blow for that company. Another bad move in a list of bad moves made over the past year. I mean, you know you're in a bad situation financially when somebody breaks in to, you know, into a place and only steals the iPads. They leave all the Surface tablets. I mean, that just shows you the power of a name. So definitely, BlackBerry, isn't going to recover like Microsoft did. So I strongly, you know, recommend if you have any BlackBerry stock, I strongly recommend you sell it. Hulu Plus, talking about them, they inked a big deal, obviously, to get more shows. But another move for them that put them in the news this week, obviously, a Chromecast app that is out now for them. So starting the, another thing for Hulu, just showing you the Chromecast is here to stay. Obviously, it's one of the best-selling, streaming devices ever, fastest-selling. And now that Hulu's on there, I think it's only a matter of time now before we get, you know, an HBO on there and get a lot. I think you'll watch it develop, very, very quickly. And Hulu's up there now, so good for them. Dell unveils a line of Android tablets and Windows tablets. That was obviously on Dell's site. It was a big announcement by Dell this week. Some of these actually look, fairly promising when you start talking about, hardware. When you start looking at they unveiled 11, the Dell Venue 11 Pro. It's 10.8-inch tablet with a full HD screen. Very, very cool. The Venue 8. Which is really neat as well. They released that. There's a lot of neat things they're coming out with. And, let's not forget as well, this week, Amazon releasing a new Kindle Fire just on time, like they do every year this time of year, right before the Christmas time, and dropping the price of the old one. So, a lot of stuff coming out of the pipe as far as hardware wise, because it's getting towards that time of year, the Christmas season. Everybody always unveils the new electronics. It's just the way it is. Spotify, of course, coming out with a new thing as well, kind of like a Chromecast for music type of thing. That's something else, obviously, that's out now that they're doing, and a lot of obviously the Samsung Watch. That's coming out now as well. So it's that time of year again, folks. So, Christmas is coming around the corner here very shortly. And, of course, we're going to get a lot of electronics coming out as the Christmas season just creeps closer and closer. PayPal mobile app lets you order ahead of time at restaurants. That was, of course, that was news. I believe that was news on Yahoo this past week. But, obviously, coming out with a way to kind of pay and all that before you get to the places. So that's kind of a neat thing that came out this weekend. I think we kind of wrapped up. I mean, sure, there's more news I'm sure we can go over, but I think that kind of hits it up for the big ticket items, for the last week or so. And some of the stuff as well that I'm looking at here, quite a few things actually that some other things too that we can talk about. Microsoft recycles inactive Outlook, Hotmail, and email accounts, apparently a report saying. As well as, let's not forget too, one thing I forgot to mention is that Twitter going public very, very soon. So they're working towards a big IPO. So we'll see how that goes. I'm sure they'll do very, very well. They're them and Facebook, I mean, they're here to stay. I was actually a little bit wrong on them. I didn't think Twitter and Facebook were going to last as long as they did. But, I was wrong on that. I admit I'm wrong on that. And, apparently both are here to stay for a while. So, they're not going anywhere. But now they're filing for an IPO. So good for them. We'll get to the questions. Not as many questions as I was like. The questions, I know we were getting tons of views on the podcast. I mean, there's no, or tons of listeners on the pod. Man, I'm rusty after 2 weeks of not doing this. I've been on the rusty side. Plus, too, we also have had some technical problems this particular podcast as well. Not as many questions as I was like. I noticed we're getting a lot of listens for the podcast, not as many questions. But if you ask your questions, I'll more than happily put them up on the podcast. So the first one I got is, can I install a Blu-ray player into my laptop? You can. Blu-ray players are definitely becoming more popular. You can install a Blu-ray player on your laptop if you can get an internal Blu-ray player for your particular model laptop. You're going to have to actually do some research on that one. But in answer to your question, yes, I think you probably could go ahead and get a Blu-ray. Blu-ray is actually neat because not only can you use it to watch videos, you can also burn several gigs of data on onto a disk. There's a lot of things you can do. It depends on what you want to do. Not a lot of machines do have Blu-ray readers, so it'd be a little bit difficult if you're going to burn disks and stuff for people to take home with them. So, but do remember, you can't. You can't copy movies or anything. That is piracy. So I know. I don't think that's what you're asking me, but I'm just saying. Some other things as well. Looking at the questions, we got some interesting questions. Some of them actually, I have to say, are not going to make the air this week, only because the questions weren't like, I got one right here right now. My printer's not working. That doesn't really tell me enough. So questions like that, again, folks, I ask you all the time. If you're going to send me questions on the site, thetechnologygeek.org, submit any of your questions. I'll be more than happy to answer them on the podcast. But I do need you to ask me full questions and give me all the information you can. One question I did have, which is a good one, how do I back up my Android phone? That's actually a really good question. The way you back up your Android phone, most of your contacts should be backed up through Google. I know myself when I got rid of my old Android phone and got a brand new one. I know as soon as I did log into my account, and all my contacts came back. So all your contacts should be backed up. If not, check in the settings and there is a backups tab, and you should be able to find your backups through there. So I would recommend definitely going through, but they're going through, making sure that's so you don't lose all your contacts, because there's nothing really more painful than that. But there is Nova Launch is one, Dropbox, LastPass for your passwords, Helium backups one you can do, Titanium backups one, but you have to root your phone. I don't know if you want to do that. There's definitely, quite a bit you can, there's quite a few options for that, on the, as far as backup options for the Android phone goes. The next question I have, which is kind of a neat one, this is kind of why it made the podcast this week. What's the best laptop that's also a tablet? That was actually a neat one. The argument that could be the Surface, because you can have a keyboard with it. I mean, that's argument. You can also get there's some other ones out there too. The Sony Vaio Duo, that's like a tablet with a keyboard, runs Windows 8. That's an option. Lenovo Yoga makes one. The Asus Transformer is another one. You got a lot of options there as far as what you could do. With that. I'm trying to think. I mean, there's the only few I can actually think of right now off the top of my head. Because you're basically, I think what you're trying to ask me is I would say probably the Surface is one that I would definitely go with if I was going to go that route. I know there's a, and there's some other stuff coming out. There's some other Asus models coming out, later on this year. So that might be something you might want to look into, as far as if you're looking for a tablet that's also going to be dubbed as a laptop. Some other questions as well. Somebody sent me a question. I installed a new drive in my Mac and I cannot format it. There's a very good reason why you can't do that. You actually have to go into disk management, and you're going to actually have to go ahead and create a partition for it. It's not like Windows. It doesn't walk you through it like that. You're going to actually have to go in there and actually create a partition, and then you can go ahead and create a partition name, and then you can just go ahead and format it using the disk. Another question, too, you're going to ask is, how can I, I know a lot of people ask me all the time, well, I got it from the App Store. How can I burn a disk? I don't think you can. I think you're going to actually have to go ahead and actually buy the disk if you don't already have it. Another question I had, the last question, which is pretty good, is what external DNS service can I use besides my ISPs? The answer to that is I use Google's 8.8.8.8 and 8.8.4.4. That's what I use for external DNS. I don't even use my ISP's DNS. That's what I would do. So a lot of good questions this week. Unfortunately, some of them didn't make the podcast because there's just not enough information. If you want to go ahead, folks, and resend them to me, again, I'll be more than willing to answer them, but unfortunately I can't answer them if they're not fully given to me. So well, I want to thank everybody for listening to this podcast. And apologize, we did have some technical difficulties, had some audio issues as well earlier, but I think we fixed them before we posted and all that. So I want to thank everybody for listening, and we will see you next week. And as always, we're going to give you some music on the way out, one of my favorite tracks, and enjoy it. Thank you very much for listening, and we'll see you next week.
This ain't a song for the broken hearted. Smile!